Each pupil book has 36 units of work. Most units deal with one sound. Some units, called combined sound units, cover two phonemes. Whether it is a single sound or combined sound unit, each unit represents 1 week's work. Details of how to break that into a Monday to Friday approach are given in the teacher guide. The teacher guide outlines a three-step approach to teaching the unit. The first step of the week is to explore the sound. This is done by brainstorming the sound with the pupils and exploring the list words. You will notice that the list words are presented with a mixture of the different graphemes. This is to ensure that pupils engage with the words and explore the different graphemes for the sound. They underline or highlight the letter or letters that represent the targeted phoneme in the word. Sometimes there are words which use different graphemes. For example, the E-I-G-H of eight and the E-Y of they. The pupils record these in separate boxes. The second step in the week's work is focused on working with words. The pupil book covers a range of different activities to help the pupils with the words, covering the writing and reading of words with the target sound. Let's take a more detailed look at one of the units from the first class book. It's unit 13, which deals with the A, as in snail, phoneme. At the top of the unit, the graphemes for the A sound are displayed, along with key icon images. In this example, snail, hay, and cake.